The ladies' giant slalom took centre stage on day 5 on the Olympic slope in Hafjell, as 56 starters lined up for the first of 2 runs down the course, the quickest combined times determining the Youth Olympic Games skiing medalists. Melanie Maillard of Switzerland set the early pace. The slaloms are more technical than the Super-G sprints. The gates are placed closer together, forcing the athletes to make faster and shorter turns. Melanie finished in 1:17.84. Next to go was Germany's Katrin Hertel-Stangassinger. It was icy at the top end of the course, a real challenge for the skiers. But Katrin took it in her stride and looked in good form. Her time of 1:17.80 put her into the lead. The Swiss team had high hopes for the giant slalom, and Aline Danioff proved she was up to the task. Showing skill and determination, she always looked in control. With the finish in sight, she recorded a time just 66 hundredths of a second behind the leader. If the start was difficult, the final section was no easier. Kim van Roozel took a tumble and needed help to get back on her feet, but the Belgian was okay to eventually make her way down. So at the halfway stage, Germany's Katrin Hertel-Stangassinger was in first place, Melanie Maillard just 400th of a second behind, and her Swiss teammate Aline Danioff was in third position. The competition for places was to be keenly contested. Some spectators, though, were just having fun. The last few metres to the finish line in the second run were going to be crucial. Amelia Smart of Canada tried just a little too hard. Aline Danioff was the first to go of the potential medal winners. In third place after the first run, she wanted a quick time. With a gold in the combined event and a bronze from the Super-G, it's already been a good week for the Swiss skier. She finished in 2:33.95. Melanie Maillard was next. She came second in the combined, and the question was, could the Swiss team make it a 1-2 again? Melanie was flying, quickest through the sections. She was inching into the lead with the finish in sight. What would the time be? She crossed the line at 67 hundredth of a second in front. In reality, less than a blink of the eye. Now it was all down to Katrin Hertel-Stangassinger. The German won silver in the combined race on day 3, so she too was full of confidence. It was neck and neck as Katrin steered past the gates. She held the lead after the opening race, and would that be the advantage that would make the difference? But as she finished, her time was 2:33.34, 600th of a second behind the leader. It couldn't have been closer. It was also a big day for Elizabeth Olivier, South Africa's only athlete here. She completed her ambition of finishing both races and was thrilled by her experience of the Youth Olympic Games. So the final ladies' giant slalom placings. Melanie Maillard of Switzerland in gold medal position. Germany's Katrin Hertel-Stangassinger taking silver. And winning bronze, Switzerland's Aline Danioff. A good day for the Swiss team on the Olympic slope, and the Germans were happy as well.
I'm really happy about this victory, it's magic. My family is really happy about this achievement. My family is here as well, and my friends, they're really happy and proud of me at home too.
I know that I can do it, but now it's cool.
And now you have the medals, how do you feel?
I'm so happy, and yes, I can't describe it. It's a really good feeling.
Aline, many congratulations. How do you feel today?
Yes, I feel good. Again on the podium 3 times, that's cool.
What does that mean to you to have these 3 medals?
Yes, it means a lot to me. That's so cool to have a medal in every discipline.
Are they heavy? You've got 3 medals around your neck. Is it heavy?
Yes, it's heavy. I hope it's getting heavier next time with another medal.
It's been absolutely amazing. It's so much fun meeting all the people, all the children. And I met athlete role model Dominique, and she's just amazing. She's inspired me. She helped me on. Gave me some good advice.